morning, children. In today's class, we are going to revise for the CRP portions, okay? We are going to revise CRP part 1 portions. So, what are the part 1 portions we are going to learn today? From your textbook, lesson 6, Omana's journey. Lesson 7, from the window. Then, lesson 8, reaching grandmother's house. These three lessons are a combined lesson. Then, lesson 9, changing families. Lesson 12, changing times. Lesson 13, a reverse tale. Lesson 17, Nandita in Mumbai. Lesson 18, too much water, too little water. These three lessons are also a combined lesson. Then, lesson 12, air, water, weather. Then, lesson 10, states of matter. And finally, lesson 7, circulatory system and excretory system. So, we have many lessons, yes, children. So, one by one we will revise, okay? First, we will revise the classwork notes. Then, followed by notes of lesson, your NOL. Then, finally, we will revise the workbook exercise. Shall we start, students? So, before I start, I want all of you to revise along with me, okay? When you are seeing this video, along with me, you also should revise, children. Then only you can concentrate more and you can memorize it very well. So first, I will start with the classwork notes. From your classwork, first we will revise Lesson 6, Omana's Journey, Lesson 7, From the Window, and Lesson 8, Reaching Grandmother's House. Okay? First, fill in the blanks. First question. The ticket collector checked tickets during Omana's journey. So, Omana, she was traveling in the train, yes? So, when the train is moving, who will check the tickets, children? The person who checks the ticket is called ticket collector. So, the ticket collector, he checked Omana's tickets, yes? So, the answer is ticket collector. Spelling T-I-C-K-E-T, ticket collector. C-O-L-L-E-C-T-O-R, ticket collector. The ticket collector checked tickets during Omana's journey. Then the second one, Gandhidham is in Kutch district of Gujarat. So Gandhidham, where it is located? It is from Kutch district. Spelling of Kutch, K-U-T-C-H, Kutch. K-U-T-C-H, Kutch. Gandhidham is in Kutch district of Gujarat. Third one, they took a ferry to cross the river. To cross the river, what was used, children? Ferry. So, Omana, once they reached the village, they took a ferry to cross the river. The answer is ferry. F-E-R-R-Y, ferry. F-E-R-R-Y, ferry. Fourth one, Kozhikode is in the state of Kerala. Kozhikode, where it is located? It is the state of Kerala. Spelling K-E-R-A-L-A, Kerala. K-E-R-A-L-A, Kerala. Fifth one, a way built through a mountain is called tunnel. So, a way, okay? In between the mountains, if you want to go, a way will be built, yes? So, what is the name called? It is called tunnel. T-U-N-N-E-L, tunnel. T-U-N-N-E-L, tunnel. A way built through a mountain is called tunnel. Second Roman letter is true or false. First one, bridges are not used by the trains to cross the rivers. It is a false statement. Yes, bridges, we are using it to cross rivers. Yes, children? Yes, so it is false. F-A-L-S-E, false. Bridges are not used by the trains to cross rivers. Second one, the route from Goa to Kerala has 92 tunnels. It is true, yes. In the textbook, you would have learnt. From Goa to Kerala, if you are going, there are 92 tunnels. So, the answer is true. T-R-U-E, true. The route from Goa to Kerala has 92 tunnels. Third one, people wait by the side of level crossing for the train to pass. So, when the train is passing, where will the people stand?
They will stand by the side of level crossing.
So the answer is true. It is true. People wait by the sides of level crossing for the train to pass. Fourth one, Gandhinagar and Ahmedabad stations are in Gujarat. So Gujarat, we have Gandhinagar and Ahmedabad stations. The answer is true. T-R-U-E, true. Fifth one, Maghuman lies in the state of Rajasthan. It is false. Maghuman lies in the state of Rajasthan. It is a false statement. The next we are going to revise is match the following. First one, ferry. Ferry, I told you, it is a water transport. Ferry, water transport. Second one, coconut trees. Where do we find coconut trees? Banks of the river. Coconut trees, banks of the river. Then Konkani, it is a language spoken in Goa. Konkani, Goa. Fourth one, Malayalam, it is spoken in Kerala. Malayalam, Kerala. Fifth one, Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad, it is from Valsad station. Ahmedabad, Valsad station. The next lesson we are going to revise is lesson 9, changing families, and lesson 12, changing times. Again, fill in the blank, students. First one, a person works with wood is called carpenter. So a person who is working with wood, we call them carpenter. Spelling C-A-R-P-E-N-T-E-R. Carpenter. A person works with wood is called carpenter. Second one, after partition, Chetan Das moved from Dera Ghazi Khan in Pakistan to a place near Delhi. So, after there was a partition in India and Pakistan, Chetan Das, he moved from Pakistan to where he moved? He moved to Delhi. The answer is Delhi. D-E-L-H-I. Delhi. Third one, Prohibition of Child Marriage Act is a law. So child marriage we should not do in our country, children. It is against the law. So the answer is child. C-H-I-L-D. Child. Prohibition of Child Marriage Act is a law. Second Roman letter, true or false? First question, multi-story buildings are seen in big cities. We can see multi-story buildings in big cities. Yes or no? Yes. So the answer is true. T-R-U-E. True. Second one, cow dung mixture is used to coat floors in village to prevent insects. So cow dung mixture, they will mix it with the floors. Okay, they will coat the floors for what, children? To prevent insects. The answer is true. Third one, in cities, people use cement, concrete and iron to build strong houses. In cities, you will be seeing, yes, what people will use to construct a house? They will use cement, concrete and iron to build a strong house. So the answer is true. Fourth one, the panchayat said that young children should not study and should get married soon. The answer is false. Did panchayat say it like that, children? No, they will not say like that. Children, they wanted to study, yes, they were allowed to study. But the statement here, it is false. The panchayat said that young children should not study and get married soon. It is a false statement. A Roman letter, match the following. First question, division of country. Division of country, India and Pakistan. In this lesson, you would have learned two countries, they were partitioned. So it is India and Pakistan. Second one, termites. So termites, the answer is neem and kikar trees. Okay, neem and kikar trees. Third one, walls, unbaked bricks. Walls, unbaked bricks. So the next portion we are going to revise is lesson 13, a river state. Lesson 17, Nandita in Mumbai. Lesson 18, too much water, too little water. Then from your workbook, lesson 10, states of matter. And lesson 12, air, water and weather. First we will revise, fill in the blanks. First question, water becomes dirty by human activity. So how the water is becoming dirty, children? By human activity. The answer is dirty. D-I-R-T-Y, dirty, D-I-R-T-Y, dirty. Second one, people use river water for domestic purpose. People use river water, okay, for what are they using it? For domestic purpose. The answer is river water, R-I-V-E-R, river water, W-A-T-E-R, water. Third one, Nandita went to Mumbai for the treatment of her mother. Nandita, she went to Mumbai, we learned in the lesson. For what she went to Mumbai? For her mother's treatment. The answer is Mumbai, M-U-M-B-A-I, Mumbai. Fourth one, mixing of industrial waste into the river causes water pollution. So, if the industrial waste, if it gets mixed with the water, what will happen? It will cause water pollution. The answer is water, W-A-T-E-R, water. Next, we are going to revise this, true or false. First one, the toilet was very neat and clean. The answer is false. In Mumbai, where Nandita went, the toilet was not at all clean. Yes? So the answer is false. Second one, chlorine is added to water to kill the germs. It is true. Yes. To kill the germs, we will add chlorine to the water. The answer is true. Third one, evaporation of water is low in summer. It is false. During the summer season, evaporation will be high student. So the answer is false. Evaporation of water is low in summer. It is false. Fourth one, diarrhea can be dangerous if we do not take care. It is true. So when we have diarrhea, if you get diarrhea, you should be very cautious. Okay, we should take care of ourselves. So it can be dangerous if we are not taking care. The answer is true. Diarrhea can be dangerous if we do not take care. It is true. The next we are going to revise is match the following. First one, waterborne diseases. They are cholera and typhoid. So waterborne diseases, cholera and typhoid. Second one, filtration. It is water purification. Filtration, water purification. Third one, insoluble in water. Stone and plastic, they will not dissolve in water. So insoluble in water, stone and plastic. Boiling of water kills germs. If we boil the water, it will kill the germs. So boiling of water kills germs. We have one diagram also, children, in this lesson. The diagram is draw the filtration method. So here you can easily see the filtration method. Yes, you have to draw beakers, then the stand, then the spatula, everything you have to draw. Okay, stand, beakers, then you have to mark each one of them. You have to mark and you have to write it in pencil. So it is an easy diagram. Using scale, pencil, eraser, you have to draw it. Once if you practice 3 to 4 times, you will get to know all the answers. Okay. So practice well, students. Only one diagram you have in this lesson. So students, the next one you are going to revise is from your NOL. I want all of you to take your NOL and revise along with me. First, we will revise the lessons. Okay. What are the lessons in NOL? We have lesson 30, a reverse tape. Lesson 70, Nandita in Mumbai. Lesson 18, too much water, too little water. Then from your workbook, lesson 10, states of matter. And lesson 12, air, water and weather. So only one NOL portions you have in CRP part 1, students. We will revise value based points now. First one, solid, liquid and gas are the 3 states of water. Okay. So what are the 3 states? We have solid, liquid and gas. Okay. Solid, liquid and gas are the 3 states of water. Then second one, water vapor is the gaseous form of water. So water vapor, in what form it is, children? It is in the form of gaseous. Okay. Gaseous form of water. Water vapor is the gaseous form of water. Third one, rain is the main natural source of water. So rain, we get it directly. Yes. So it is the natural source of water. Fourth one, the two types of impurities present in water are soluble and insoluble impurities. We have two types of impurities, children. What are the two types? They are soluble impurities and insoluble impurities. So you have to write the answer correct, okay? Fifth one, the solid that dissolves in a liquid is called solute, okay? A solid. For example, if you take sugar, okay? If you are dissolving it in water, okay? It is called solute, okay? The solid that dissolves in a liquid is called solute. Then, sixth one, the liquid in which solute dissolves is called solvent, okay? The liquid in which the solute, the liquid, then the solute, you have taken the sugar solution, yes? So, if you are mixing it with the liquid, then it is called solvent, okay? The liquid in which solute dissolves is called solvent. Then the seventh one, strong wind is called gale. Strong wind, it is called gale, okay? If there is a strong wind, what do we call? We call them gale. The next Roman letter is answer in short, okay? Short answers. First question, write two steps to overcome water scarcity. So we have to write A, two steps to overcome. How can we overcome water scarcity? First point, recycle wastewater. So we can recycle the wastewater, children. Second point, desalination of seawater. So we can desalinate the seawater also. The spelling of recycle, R-E-C-Y-C-L-E, recycle. Then desalination, D-E-S-A-L-I-N-A-T-I-O-N, desalination. So what are the two steps, children? Recycle of wastewater, desalination of seawater. The second question, write the three states of matter with an example. So we know the three states of matter. Yes, what are the three states of matter? The three states of matter are solid, liquid and gas. So we have to write the examples also. Solid, example ice. Liquid, example water. Gas, example oxygen, okay? Solid, S-O-L-I-D, solid. Liquid, L-I-Q-U-I-D. Then gas, G-A-S, gas. The three states of matter are solid, example ice, liquid, example water, then gas, example oxygen. Third one, what is matter? What is matter, students? Anything that has mass and occupies space is called matter. So anything that has mass, okay, and occupies space is called matter. So spelling of mass, M-A-S-S, mass. Then matter, M-A-T-T-E-R, matter. Fourth one, define water cycle. Okay, the continuous movement of water between the land, water bodies and air is known as water cycle. Okay, there will be a continuous movement, children. Between the land, water bodies and air is known as water cycle. Okay, water cycle spelling, W-A-T-E-R, water cycle, C-Y-C-L-E, water cycle. Fifth one, name some factors that affect the weather of a place. So, some factors we have to list, children, which will affect the weather of a place. Sun, wind, clouds and water vapor are the factors that affect the weather of a place. Sun, wind, clouds and water vapor are the factors that affect the weather of a place. Sun, S-U-N, sun. Wind, W-I-N-D, wind. Then water vapor, W-A-T-E-R, V-A-P-O-U-R, water vapor. So these are some factors that affect the weather of a place. The next Roman number is answering paragraph. Explain the methods to separate insoluble impurities in water. So we have to write the methods how we can separate the impurities in water. Okay, the three steps I will tell you first. First method is sedimentation. First method, sedimentation. And the second method is decantation. Second method, decantation. And the third method is filtration. Sedimentation, decantation and filtration. First one, sedimentation. Settling down of insoluble impurities present in water. Settling down. Okay, if any impurities is present in water, it will be settled down. So this method is called sedimentation. S-E-D-I-M-E-N-T-A-T-I-O-N. Sedimentation. Second one, decantation. This follows sedimentation. The clean water above the impurities is poured into another container. Okay, the impurities will be settled down and the clean water will be there on the top. Yes children, so this clean water, it will be poured into another container. So this method is called decantation. Spelling of decantation, D-E-C-A-N-T-A-T-I-O-N, decantation. Then the last method is filtration, the removal of insoluble impurities by straining or using filter paper. Okay, the removal, we can remove the insoluble impurities by straining it or we can use a filter paper also. So this method, it is filtration. Spelling of filtration, F-I-N-T-R-A-T-I-O-N, filtration. So once again, I'll read out all the three methods children. They are sedimentation, decantation and filtration. Sedimentation, settling down of insoluble impurities present in water. Then decantation, this follows sedimentation. The clean water above the impurities is poured into another container. Then last method, filtration, the removal of insoluble impurities by straining or using filter paper. The next one we are going to revise is from your workbook. Okay, take lesson 12, air, water and weather. See the first question, match the pictures correctly to their name. So here some pictures are given and you have to match it to the correct name. First picture, it is snow. Yes, the first picture we have to match it to snow. Second one, it is hail. Yes, the second one, it is hail. Then the third one, it is fog. Third one, the third picture, it is fog students. Then the fourth one, it is frost. Fourth one, it is frost. Then the fifth one, it is dew. Yes, so you have to match all the pictures to the correct names. Next one, unscramble and fill the correct answer. Okay, here some answers, they are unscrambled and you have to write the correct answer. First one, the process by which water changes to water vapor on heating is dash. Okay, water, it is changing to water vapor. So the answer, it is evaporation. Spelling, E-V-A-P-O-R-A-T-I-O-N, evaporation. The second question, when the water vapor cools to form drops of water is known as dash. The answer is condensation. When the water vapor, it is cooled down, okay, like water vapor, it will form the drops of water. It is known as condensation. Spelling, C-O-N-D-E-N-S-A-T-I-O-N, condensation. Third one, dash is the process by which water drops become very heavy and come down as rain to earth. Okay, the third answer, the process by which the water drops, okay children, the water drops, it will become very heavy and it will come down in the form of rain. The answer is precipitation. So in the process of precipitation only the water, it will come down in the form of brain. Our spelling PRECIPITATION. Precipitation. Fourth one, the process of removing insoluble particles from water by using filter. Okay, the process when we remove the insoluble particles from the water, it is known as filtration. Spelling FILTRATION. Filtration. Next question.
Fill the percentage of air in the atmosphere.
So here a pie chart is given. Yes, so here you can see oxygen, nitrogen and other. So we have to fill the percentage of air, children. How much percentage of air it is there in atmosphere? So oxygen 21%. Okay, oxygen 21%. Nitrogen 78%. So nitrogen it is more, 78%. Then others, how many percent? 78 and 21%, if you add, only 1% balance will be there. Okay, so 1% other air are present. Okay, oxygen 21%, nitrogen 78%, and others 1%. Next question, answering one word. What is the level of underground water at a place? Okay, what will be the level, children? The answer is water table. So you have to look at the water table. WATER, water table. TABLE, water table. Second one, which chemical is added to water to kill germs? So what chemical do we add? The answer is chlorine. 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 Third one, what are the two types of impurities that should be removed from water? We have already discussed this in the NOL. They are soluble and insoluble impurities. Soluble and insoluble impurities. Spelling SOLUBLE. Soluble, then insoluble. INSOLUBLE. Soluble and insoluble impurities. Then fourth one, mention the cool breeze that blows from the sea to the land. Okay, the cool breeze which will blow from the sea to the land. The answer is sea breeze. Spelling SEAC breeze. BREEZE. Sea breeze. Next question, fill the water cycle. So here some boxes are given, children. We have to fill the correct answer. So the first one, what is the answer, children? It is evaporation. Okay, the water, it gets evaporated. Yes, so the answer is evaporation. Then after evaporation, what will happen? The process condensation will happen. Yes, you have to write the answer, condensation. Then after condensation, the waters, it will come down in the form of precipitation. Yes, you are right. The answer is precipitation. At last, it is water table. Yes, the answer, it is water table. So you have to write the correct spelling. Next question, how do you think water cycle is affected? How a water cycle will be affected, children? Major human processes like irrigation, urbanization, combustion, deforestation, wetlands, etc. affects the water cycle. So these are the major human processes. So they are irrigation, urbanization, combustion, deforestation, wetlands, etc. Spelling of irrigation, IRRIGATION. Irrigation. Urbanization, URBANIZATION. Urbanization. Then combustion, COMBUSTION. Deforestation, DEFORESTATION. Deforestation. Wetlands, WETLANDS. Wetlands. So these are the major human processes which will affect the water cycle. The next question, what does fluoridation give reason? Fluoridation is the controlled addition of fluoride chloride to a public water supply to reduce tooth decay. So fluoridation means it is a controlled addition, children, of fluoride to a public water supply to reduce tooth decay. Fluoridation, spelling FLUORIDATION. Fluoridation. Then fluoride spelling FLUORIDE. Fluoride. So fluoridation is the controlled addition of fluoride to a public water supply to reduce tooth decay. Next question. Why is not advisable to carry an umbrella during the storm or lightning? Why it is not advisable, children, to carry an umbrella during thunderstorm or lightning? It is not safe because the iron rod or iron anvil can conduct electricity and we may get electric shock. So if you carry an umbrella, suppose the umbrella it has iron rod or iron anvil, what will happen? Through that the electricity may pass, we may get electric shock. So it is not advisable to carry an umbrella during lightning or thunderstorm. The next lesson from your workbook is lesson 10, states of matter. First, you can see match the objects to the respective matter. So solid, liquid and gas. You have to match the correct answer, children. Here you can see the solid items. They are book and a ping pong cup. Yes, so these are solid. Then the liquid item is oil, water. Then the gas item, you can see the perfume. So these are the solid, liquid and gas. Next question, take the correct statement. First one, gases have definite shape. Do gases have definite shape? No, it is wrong. The statement is wrong. Second one, liquids have definite mass. It is correct statement. Yes, liquids, they will have definite mass. Third one, solids have fixed volume. Solids, they have fixed volume. It is true. It is a correct statement. Then fourth one, milk mixture when cooled becomes ice cream. It is a wrong statement. Milk mixture, if we cool it, it will not become ice cream. Yes, so it is a wrong statement. Next one, fill the changes of states of matter. Here you can see three pictures. Ice cubes, then a glass of water, then boiling water. Then you can see four boxes also. Yes, you have to write the changes of matter. First, we will start with the box given down the arrow. Yes, first from ice cubes to glass of water. What is the matter changing, children? It is melting. Yes, from ice cube, if the ice cubes are changing to water, it is through melting. Yes, then from melting, what will happen? It will evaporate. The glass of water, if you are boiling, it will evaporate. So it is evaporation. Yes, again you can go to the top of the arrow. You can see from boiling, if it is changing to glass of water, so that is condensation. Yes, it is condensation. Again, the glass of water, if you are changing it to ice cubes, it is freezing. Through freezing only we will freeze the water. Yes, so it is freezing. Next question, identify the process. First one, the process where a liquid absorbs the heat and changes into gaseous state. The answer is evaporation. So evaporation only, the liquid, it will absorb the heat and it will change into gaseous form. It is evaporation. 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 Second one, the process when a liquid is cooled losses the heat energy and changes the solid state. It is freezing. 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 When the liquid, it is allowed to cool and if it is losing its heat energy, then it is freezing. Third one, the process when cooled losses heat energy and changes into liquid state. Okay, when the process, it is cooled and it is changing into the heat energy, it is condensation. 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 And the fourth one, the process where a solid absorbs heat to change into its liquid state. The answer is melting. So through melting only the solid will absorb the heat and it will change into liquid state. Spelling of melting, M-E-L-T-I-N-G, melting. Next question, identify the process from the pictures given below. The picture you can see what process it is, children. It is evaporation. You can see from the kettle, the water is getting evaporated. Yes, so the answer is evaporation. Next question, give reason. Is the smoke released from mosquito coil is good for breathing? So smoke which comes out from the mosquito coil, is it good for breathing? No, it is not good for breathing because it contains harmful substances. So the mosquito coil, the smoke which is released from that, it is not good for breathing, children. It will contain harmful substances. Second one, is the ice cubes formed in the refrigerator without pouring water is good for health? No, it is not good for health because it contains bacteria. So without pouring water, if the ice trays, if the ice cubes form automatically, it is not good for health. It contains bacteria, students. What is the boiling point of water to change into vapor? The boiling point, it is 100 degrees Celsius. What is the boiling point? 100 degrees Celsius. Fourth one, how does vapor get dry and disappear? How the vapor will get dry and disappear? Because of dry air, vapor gets dry and disappear. Because of the dry air only, the vapor, it gets dried and disappear. The next question, what is an atom? Which subject deals with the study of atom? Atom is the smallest particle of a chemical element that can exist. So it is the smallest particle, children. Atomic physics is the study of atom. Then the next question, highlight the difference between fragrance and odor. So then we have to write the difference between fragrance and odor. Fragrance, it is pleasant or sweet smell. So fragrance means the smell will be, it will be pleasant for us or it may be sweet also. Odor, it is unpleasant smell. We cannot smell that thing itself. It will be not at all good. It is unpleasant smell. The next question, observe the picture and answer how agarbattis give scented fragrance. You can see the picture of agarbattis. Yes, how it is giving a scented fragrance, children? The essential oil used in agarbattis which gives scented fragrance. So to make the agarbattis, they will use some essential oil. So these essential oil, it will make the agarbattis to smell different. A pleasant smell will be there, children. So the essential oil used in agarbattis only will give the scented fragrance. In the last workbook exercise we are going to revise is lesson 7, circulatory system and excretory system. First, match the organs to their respective systems. So what are the two systems we learn, children? Circulatory system and excretory system. Yes, so we have to match the organs. Circulatory system, what are the organs? Circulatory system match heart, then arteries and veins. Yes, heart, artery and veins. Then excretory system, kidneys, urethra. So these are the organs. Okay, so we have to match it correctly to the particular system. Then the next one, circle the right answer. So we have to write the right answer. We have to circle it. First one, our body is made up of various dash. The answer is organs. O-R-G-A-N-S. Organs. Our body is made up of various organs. Second one, dash pumps blood to all parts of the body. So what will pump the blood, children? It is heart. H-E-A-R-T. Heart. Third one, dash are very thin blood vessels. They are capillaries. Capillaries are very thin blood vessels. Spelling C-A-P-I-L-L-A-R-I-E-S. Capillaries. So fourth one, dash is made up of fluid and cells. The answer is blood. B-L-O-O-D. Blood. So blood is made up of fluid. The next one, identify the system and label the part. So what system it is, children? It is circulatory system. So it is circulatory system. C-I-R-C-U-L-A-T-O-R-Y. Circulatory system. So what is the first part? It is heart. H-E-A-R-T. Heart. Then the second, you can see the arteries. Yes. A-R-T-E-R-I-E-S. Arteries. Then the next one, it is veins. V-E-I-E-N-S. Veins. The next question, answer in one word. First question, what is the shape of kidneys? Kidneys, I told you what shape it is, children. It is bean shape. B-E-A-N. Bean shape. S-H-A-P-E-D. Shape. Bean shape. Second one, mention the process by which waste is removed from the body. So the process name is excretion. E-X-C-R-E-T-I-O-N. Excretion. Third one, what is the size of a person's heart? So a person's heart size, it is 12 centimeter.
Fourth one, which helps pass urine out of the body?
It is urethra. U-R-E-T-H-R-A. Urethra. Next question, identify the system and label the part. So what system, children? It is excretory system. E-X-C-R-E-T-O-R-Y. Excretory system. So what is the first part you can see? It is kidney. Yes, the arrow mark if you see. Kidney. K-I-D-N-E-Y. Kidney. Then the next part, it is ureter. U-R-E-T-E-R. Ureter. Then the next part, it is urinary bladder. U-R-I-N-A-R-Y. Urinary bladder. B-L-A-D-D-E-R. Bladder. Then the last part you can see, it is urethra. U-R-E-T-H-R-A. Urethra. Next question, think and answer. What is the main use of RBC, children? RBC is used to carry oxygen to all parts of our body. So RBC, what it is doing? It is carrying oxygen to all parts of our body. Second one, what happens if we have more WBC count? Our immune power will increase if we have more WBC count. So our immune power, it will increase if we have more WBC count. Third one, can human beings survive with one kidney? Give reasons. We have two kidneys, yes? So can human beings can survive with one kidney? Yes, one healthy kidney is enough to filter blood to keep body functioning normally. So one kidney is also enough, children. If one kidney is failed, even with the other kidney we can live. It is enough to filter the blood. Then, fourth one, what is the normal blood pressure level? So, we all have blood pressure level. Yes, what is the normal level? It is 120 by 80 mmHg. 120 by 80 mmHg. Next question, what is the length of blood vessels? Write a note on it. So, how long the blood vessels will be, children? The length of blood vessels is 60,000 miles. So 60,000 miles. If you just take out your blood vessels, just think, if we take out the blood vessels and if you put it outside, how long it will be? It will be 60,000 miles. It is the part of the circulatory system and helps transport blood throughout the body. So it will help transport the blood throughout the body. The last question, if you see, identify the picture. So what picture it is? It is blood vessels. It is blood vessels. B-L-O-O-D. Blood vessels. V-E-S-S-E-L-S. Blood vessels. So children, I have completed the CRP part 1 portions. I have revised thoroughly. I hope you will also revise at home. You should also revise along with me, okay? So you should see the video, you should revise very children, I wish you best of luck.